Hey, Rainbow here, and welcome to my channel. Today's topic is going to be the Sygic Map app that runs with Ducati Connect, specifically on the Ducati Multistrada family. And I've spoken about this before, but now I had an opportunity to take a big deep dive with it. And I used it exclusively to take a 1,300 mile trek one way to Texas and back. So let's talk about it. Before I continue, I'd just like to remind everyone to please like and subscribe if you don't mind, and comment below because I'm gonna go into some details. It really helps when you comment, but of course, always liking and subscribing to this channel is always appreciated, and I thank you. So the Sygic app is basically you use for directions, it's maps, and it shows up right on your TFT on the Ducati Multistrada, and in your audio, you can hear the directions that it's giving you. Now, it's, I guess, the equivalent or similar, not equivalent for sure, but similar would be like Apple Maps, Google Maps. I love Waze, I use Waze all the time. And there's some other programs that are out there. But Sygic is the one that works direct with Ducati Connect so that you don't have to have a separate navigation like I did last year. I had my GPS that I mounted, and I used that to go back and forth to Texas. This year, I said I'm not gonna mount the GPS on this bike, and instead, I opted to put my iPhone. I have an iPhone 14 Plus Pro Max, whatever the hell it's called. I kept it in the jacket pocket of my riding jacket the entire time, and I use exclusively this Sygic map. So what do I think? I think that it's functional, but there are still some connectivity issues. I found out that there are some conflicts. If you put something in the phone in your app where you want to go, and there's something, you hook it up and the previous place that you were going was already in, like the Ducati Connect was already recognized it, it has a conflict, and sometimes it'll want to send you back to your previous trip that you were taking, which makes no sense. So what I found out is, don't put anything in your phone, just do all of your searches from your TFT, which kind of sucks because now you have to go through this whole damn thing with, you know, the keyboard with one little toggle switch. And I really didn't like that. I didn't like the conflicts. That was a problem. There were times when it just routed me off of the highway for like absolutely no reason. I have no idea why. I didn't see any traffic. I didn't see any problems. And I came back on the highway 10 miles later. Don't know why I was off. And I just think that I lost position. But there was another case where it routed me off the highway in Texas. And Texas has a lot of these frontage roads that go right alongside the highway, so I was able to see, and in fact it did want to take me off, and I said, you know what, I'm not listening to you this time, and then I hit stop traffic. I should have listened to Sygic at that point. Now, in comparison, if you're used to using the Apple Maps, Google Maps, or Waze, all three of those are far superior to Sygic, and that is something that you really have to take into consideration. Ultimately, Sygic did get me to and from Florida to Texas and back. However, those connectivity problems, those trust issues, finding locations was another problem. There were issues with Sygic where I was on the app and I couldn't find my own home address, but then when I went in to go home, it showed my address. So it kind of blew my mind. There's a lot of inconsistencies. So ultimately what I think the problem with Sygic is, and it's the only thing that you can use, you cannot use another app like Waze or Apple or Google at all with this Ducati Connect, which is really the biggest problem. Sygic has a lot of bells and whistles and all these things that they're adding, but they don't have the most basic things that make a mapping program good. And that's the problem. Now, Ducati does not make Sygic. I don't believe that they have anything to do with Sygic other than that's who they chose to connect with on a Ducati Connect app for whatever reason. I really don't know. I believe Sygic is a European company, I think. So this is no reflection on Ducati, except Ducati's kind of forcing us for a mapping program to one that is really subpar. And that is the issue. All these bells and whistles they have, and if you get their premium subscription, which I did have at one point, it was not worth keeping. The other problem with Sygic is that every single state that I go through is a separate map. Every single country you go through in Europe is a separate map that you have to download, and you have to make sure that all of these maps are downloaded. Now, it does have traffic information. I don't know how up to date it is, but it does have traffic information, and as I stated, it actually was right at one point. But there are times when it just is sending me off of the beaten path for a completely unknown reason and then bringing me back on again. Now, in the past, I had problems with Sygic because their waypoints were off. For instance, my own Ducati dealership, they showed them being right literally on 95. So as I'm driving by the exit and I'm looking off of the highway, which you can't get off except for at exits, I'm looking at my Ducati dealership and Sygic says, "You've arrived." I'm like, "Well, I'm arrived if I can park along, you know, in the along the highway and then hop a fence." Yeah, so that took 2 years, but that was corrected. But I believe that feedback like this is going to let Ducati know, and I think they already know this, that they have to play ball with some other people, even if it costs a little bit more money, or it's, you can't pigeonhole us into a Sygic when it just isn't a really good program from a basic sense. Now, other problems that I had with Sygic, for example, I didn't know I was getting off an exit until literally you're right there at the exit, and it doesn't know the name of the exit, it doesn't know the exit number, it doesn't even know the street, it just says follow route. And you're expected to follow the route, but not know. And then often when you get to certain intersections off of highways and interchanges, when there are three lanes and you have to be in the middle two or the right two, it's not telling you that, it's not showing you that. And in some instances, I just had to know where I was going in order to get to where the hell I was going, because Sygic was just like, follow route, and I had to look and go, okay, three roads go this way, two roads go this way, this one goes, this is the third one it goes off, that's the one I need, and I had to like find what lane I needed to be in. So again, lots of bells and whistles, but the basics of a really good program like Apple, like Google, like Waze, they're just not there. So will it function? Yes. Will it stay connected? It's questionable. There were times when I turned the key off in order to do something, like to get gas, and I even put to stay connected, and then when I turned it back on, it was trying to take me somewhere else to another direction. So I had to cancel the route that it gave me, which came out of nowhere, and then put another route in. There were other issues where if you leave the app, and let's say I had to go to, like, I keep track of all my mileage. So when I stop for gas and I stay connected, I have to get out of the Ducati Connect app in order to get to, I have Google Sheets, and that's where I track all my gas mileage for this thing, just like I did for the V4S. It's a different video coming up, by the way. And when I did that, I went to get, and it wouldn't connect again. And then all of a sudden, Ducati Connect wouldn't connect. And then sometimes what would happen is the map would, Ducati Connect, it would connect in, the map would come on, I would start riding on the highway, and within 2 or 3 minutes, it just shut off, and all of a sudden it said, check your connection. Well, I'm already back on the highway. I don't want to pull over with tractor trailers going by me at 80 miles an hour, just so I can, so I had to just like, oh, I hope I don't have any turns soon, wait till I got to another exit, get off that exit to a safe location, and try to reset to reconnect the Ducati Connect. So that's a Ducati issue, but using Ducati with Sygic At the end of the day, it will function, but you will have problems. And that is really the issue. So would I pay for the premium for Sygic? Absolutely not, because I have in the past, didn't renew it, and I will not renew it because they're just not at the level. And if Sygic, if you are watching this, so many bells and whistles you have a ton of bells and whistles. Who cares about all those bells and whistles? You need the basics of a good program. You need waypoints that exist. You need to know what the name of an exit is. You need to know what the number of an exit is. You need to know what a crossroad is. You need to be able to find my house that has existed since 1969. Over 50 years, my house has existed. 54 years, it's been present with the same address. And you don't know where it exists. That I really can't comprehend. That's where I'm having an issue with it. So again, you could use Sygic. It probably will function. You will have connectivity problems, but that's my review after 3,000 miles. And a lot of the way back when I knew I was gonna be on the same highway for a couple of states, I just, screw it. I just disconnected it. And because number one, having the Ducati Connect with the Sygic on, it just drains the battery on your phone tremendously. So in many instances, I actually just had it plugged in to the gas tank phone holder, which I can't put it in because it overheats in there. And then I put it in my pocket. So I was, it looked like I was tethered. I had the power cord coming out of that, coming into my pocket to keep my phone charged so that I didn't lose a whole lot. And that's about it. So as far as Sygic is concerned, subpar. As far as Ducati Connect with Sygic, inconsistent. So I'm going to have to call that subpar. That's something that certainly needs to be worked on. Now, from what I understand, they were supposed to have been working on this, and there should have been a release in the beginning of the year or the first month or two of the year. That hasn't come to fruition. I'm not aware of that actually happening with Ducati. I believe I have all the current updates because this bike has been in for service. It's been in for some warranty work. They have had every opportunity to make sure that this is completely updated. But this is a Sygic specific problem as far as finding and giving you directions and telling you what lane to be and all those basic things that you have in any other application. Anyway, this is Rainbow. I hope you understand what I went through with this thing. It did work, but it was difficult. I lost time as a result and went off on some wild goose chases with it, you know, but I got to where I was going at the end of the day. So this is Rainbow. Please like, please subscribe. Thank you very much and have a good day. Bye-bye.